learn how to draw an activity diagram. So the steps are same. Go to the model, click on add diagram option and add the diagram, activity diagram here. Click on this activity diagram. So on the left hand side panel, you will see all the activity, all the options, all the tools which are needed for drawing this activity diagram. So activity diagram, it always starts with this initial node. So click on the initial node and click here. So this is your initial node. All your activity starts from here. Final node, this is your final node. It represents this particular symbol represents the final node. Your activity ends here. This is your action tab. Let's see one example for the library related case. So first the user will log in. First, let's say the user will log in. You can align it like this. This is the control flow. From here you can connect start to this login. After login, let's say user wants to take a decision whether this whether the user is registered or not. So this is a decision symbol. This is a decision symbol. Okay, this is a decision symbol. So again, control flow from login to this. Now now the output of decision you will take a decision and decision may give you an output say true or false. Okay, so either you will go here or you will go here, whether the user is registered user or not. If you want to say write some text here, okay, then say you can write like here text. You can say registered user. You are checking here whether it is a registered user or not. Registered user. You are checking here whether you are checking here as a registered user or not. If it is a registered user, say yes. If it is a registered user, or you can click here, say some kind of a text also, registered user or registered user, no. Okay. If it is a registered user, we'll write here text. If a registered user, then return the book. If it is not a registered user, then registration process will be started. Then the registration process will be started. We'll move this slightly. Okay, now it is clear. Now from here, again, if you want to return the book, okay, then let's say you want to check whether there is some pending fine or not, so again there is one decision, fine, check the fine. Okay, from here one control flow will come here. Okay, so control flow will come here. The output will be whether the fine will be is pending or fine is not pending. So we'll go here and then you will go here. Okay, again same yes no, yes no. Okay, if the fine is not pending, then give some success message here, pay fine. And after completing both the activities, terminate the end flow. Here after registration, let's say end the flow. This is a simple kind of a activity diagram wherein we have seen how this initial symbol, final symbol, action and control flow, decision can be used. Now there are two special symbols, say fork and join. So from this fork, what is the meaning of the fork? Fork means input is one input is further divided into two multiple activities. So let's say you have one activity here, then you have this fork here, okay, then you have this fork symbol here, okay, and then you have two activities here, okay. So from here you have one input, then one input is further passed on for two different actions. So this is known as fork. Now if two activities are there and if you want to join it into one activity, so this is a join symbol. This is one activity. If you want to join these two activities, join this activity into one activity. Okay, so this is a join symbol. So using these symbols or options which are available here in the star UML, you can create a sample activity diagram.